6. Cover me.
So this is the Star Trek Boomerang Phaser. This one I've already sanded down and I had to put a little bit of filler on. There are a few tiny bubbles, but I've already filled those in, sanded it down and put the first coat of primer on it. So the first steps I did was to look over the mouldings, look for any lumps or holes. If they've got a lump, obviously just sand it down. If it's a hole, use some filler. Now I use a knifing putty made by a company called Holtz in the UK, but be careful if you use it because it will melt plastic, so don't use it on plastic. So once you're happy, all the holes are filled in, it's all nice and smooth, the seams are rubbed down, I put my first coat of primer on. As you can see here, I just put a sheet of newspaper down. I've got limited space where I do my spraying, and then just spray car primer all over the mouldings. I'm just going to rub this down and start painting. I have put a hole through here with a drill, and that's because I plan to have the lithium battery in the handle and therefore need to feed the circuit wires through into the handle. I should say the grip. It's a very nice moulding, very nice moulding. The nozzle, again, it had a tiny little bubble just on the rim here, but it is easily filled in, sanded down, and the first coat of primer on it. That'll sit in like this. This is the lower hatch, which sits very nicely in there, and it comes with a tiny screw, so you can screw it and hold it in place. One word of caution, I don't know if you can see it, but here, see if I can put it on a white piece. That is a teeny tiny screw which goes through this hole here and screws into the body here to hold it all in place. Don't do what I did, which is unscrew it, put it down, forget where it was, move things around and totally lost it. So this screw is in fact a replacement I found. It's a bit bigger than the one that was actually came with the kit, but it works. I've tried it and fit it. This is actually from the back of a G-Shock watch, and this is a rubberized grip, black rubberized grip. It sits like that. Now I don't actually like these, so I'll be replacing them with some Allen head equivalents, but they'll be Allen head bolts, so I can actually use an Allen key to do them up. They just look smarter. That's the fire trigger. And there are the two select and deselect buttons, already cut out, already shaped in the kit. And they obviously sit over these holes. These are the clear Perspex pieces that go in here from the inside, and the circuit board electronics rests up against it, so you can see the red and green lights as they're selected. So they're the clear plexiglass, I suppose it is. I don't know if you can see them there, but the LEDs will shine through this. And it comes, I don't know, I'm not sure why it comes in two pieces, but it does. This is a little rubberized coat or cover, and it's to cover these buttons on the circuit board, like this. And then that goes inside the phaser, and these will rest from the top like this. You can sort of start to see how it fits into there. So there are all the parts. I'll put this in here, so it goes in like this. Obviously it needs positioning and setting in properly. And then these bits fit over like this. And so that's the basic setting or layout of the Boomerang Phaser. I've got the LEDs in here, just positioning, just getting the feel of it. These are the buttons, they're not glued in or anything, I've just put them in place. So that's the first red light that's come on. That's the fourth one from the end of the reds. And that's diagnostics. Well, the basic function's okay. So you get a rough idea where everything goes.
Thank you. Maximum setting. If you fired this, you would have vaporized me.
It's my first ray gun.
So I've never built one of these kits before, but it looks pretty straightforward. There's going to be some little things that you know about. So here, for instance, you either put this reflective tape in there, if you've got any, or I believe on the Roddenberry one, they paint it using Tamiya paint, some sort of metallic blue, which I've actually got. So I might put a piece of that under there. And then there's this. This is just a piece of blue tape, but the piece of blue tape is holding down the blue reflective strip. So that's even better. I probably won't paint it, and I'll stick that in place there. I didn't know that was there. That's pretty awesome. So there we are. I've no idea what that's for. Basically, as I look at it now, I'm not going to use that. But it must be there for a reason, and I cannot for the life of me think what the reason is. And I'm really looking forward to having a go at this. And here's a thought. Maybe it's a piece of mylar or plastic paper to keep this piece protected. Maybe that's all it's for. Thanks for watching. Stay safe, and I'll see you in part 2.